Welcome to a new edition of the Neon Jazz Interview Series with the president of Buttonwood Financial Group and a key architect of Kansas City Alive, Mr. Jon McGraw. Bird is 100 in 2020, and this COVID-19 world with the pandemic is taking out live events, and it's going to be a little different this year for the 7th annual Charlie Parker Centennial Celebration, with musical performances, tributes, and education that are going to continue. It's a time for Kansas City to celebrate Bird in the spotlight here in 2020, a jubilant citywide celebration of life and music throughout the month of August. KC Alive, the University of Missouri, Kansas City, the American Jazz Museum, Nelson-Atkins Museum of Art, Mutual Musicians Foundation, Bruce Watkins Cultural Center, and other cultural and civic organizations will host jam sessions, tours, lectures, exhibits, panel discussions, poetry slams, workshops, and concerts. It's going to be a symbol of recovery and resilience this year. Jon talks about this and so much more. Enjoy.
Jon, thank you first and foremost for taking a little time out to talk about the Charlie Parker festivities in this very surreal year of 2020. He's 100, and I wish the circumstances were better for this.
Yeah, no, thanks for continuing to raise the flag to make everybody aware of all the stuff that's happening. It truly is a unique time.
Yeah, and I guess that's the thing. You know, before we get into Bird, I think my first question here is, the weird thing about what we're living through right now is it's almost kind of like that 9/11 moment. Like, where were you at when the second plane went in? Like, early to mid-March, and as we went forward, when did all of these thoughts start getting, because I know there was a lot of things planned prior to this for the Bird celebration. Not only do we do a fabulous job in Kansas City every year, 100-year anniversary is always such a big deal. When did things start kind of getting modified and solidified and modified and all of that to where we're at today?
Probably, I would throw it in the March category. I mean, this will be our 7th year of doing Spotlight Charlie Parker, or the events that go around this time of year. And we start planning, literally, we wrap it up in August, we take off September, and we start thinking about it again in October. So,
wow.
We started kind of queuing up. We usually do, at that point, monthly meetings, maybe every 3 weeks or something, kind of depending upon if we want to feel aggressive or not, you know, what new things do we want to roll out for the next year. You know, things were on a pretty good track. We've had a great committee this year. There was, co-chairs, Jake Wagner and Chuck Haddix, kind of led the group. There's been about 8 or 10 of us that have been meeting on a regular basis since the end of 2019 to kind of pull everything together. We had, obviously, you might imagine, a few more in-person events that were out there. And as things continued to unfold, it was a bit of a moving part. It was like, we want to do this, we want to do this. Okay, yeah, it's not going to happen. And then, you know, slowly but surely, things kind of came together. And we've really seen there's now in excess of 20 events that are happening. And, you know, there was a little, is it going to happen, is it going to happen? And then, boom, it either did or it didn't. And now we're off and rolling. So came together well.
Well, I guess that's the whole thing about this. I mean, when it started, everybody started doing live streaming. You know, the jazz world is used to having situations of uncertainty thrown at them so that they can make something beautiful out of it. I guess this whole celebration will just be another testament to that notion.
I love it. I'm right there with you. This has been a perfect, you know, let's just improvise. We can do this.
Right. That's what we do. I guess the one thing before we do actually get into the events, so that we can kind of have a synopsis that makes sense to folks out there so they can get involved. I mean, you know, Bird is not only something, I mean, he's a Kansas City treasure, but he transcends the jazz. He transcends all of these things. I mean, he is such an artistic mogul. We're at the 100 year. Why is it that Bird has always retained this timeless quality, and why should Kansas City celebrate that?
So I've been asked that question a variety of different ways in different places, and I think I'll answer it from a Jazz Alive perspective. And one of the reasons that we started with the idea of having an event around Charlie Parker, quickly from a music standpoint, obviously just a game changer, right, all the way across. And so everybody's more or less, I think, familiar with Parker and his history and kind of how he really made the music what it was or what it became. from a recognition standpoint, from a Kansas City standpoint, what does Charlie Parker mean to Kansas City? And when we were first formed back, I guess this would have been 2013, 14, we were thinking, what could everybody in Kansas City that cares about jazz or is interested in jazz get behind, right? I mean, is there something that we could be doing that would bring everybody together, that would unite people? And Charlie Parker kept surfacing. It's just, you know, here's somebody that Kansas City should really be loving on, right? And So that was the idea. Let's see what we can do. Will everybody get behind Charlie Parker? And so we started the celebration in August around his birthday, and we did a lot of the promotion and the production of that in the first few years. And after we'd done that for, I guess it was about 5 years, last year we came out and said, what if we didn't actually produce anything and we simply shine the spotlight on all the things that were happening in Kansas City related to Charlie Parker around his birthday? And lo and behold, there were probably 30-something items that landed on the calendar last year. And this year, again, we're 20-something events, which in the world that we're living in today is pretty darn good. And it's basically Kansas City coming together to celebrate one of the legacies truly from Kansas City.
In the actual list of events that are taking place, the first one is a jazz storytelling event that will be outside the American Jazz Museum on August 7th from 10 to 11 a.m. And then that kicks off an entire level of celebration that will culminate with Bird's Birth on the 29th. That's going to be a jazz walk and a show later. So give me, in your words, kind of a synopsis and highlights of events that will be taking place, what folks can get involved with, and obviously it's been altered because of this virtual world that we're in now because of the pandemic.
I'm going to direct everybody to the website because in our world, things are changing on a regular basis. So the website is going to have the most up-to-date information on it, and that website is spotlightcharlieparker.org, spotlightcharlieparker.org, and you'll see the word schedule. Click on schedule, boom, you'll get the latest schedule. And we're updating this daily, so really the best place to go. And, you know, from a highlight standpoint, we have traditionally done two tracks for Spotlight Charlie Parker Celebration. And one was the venue showcase. What we wanted to do was bring some big talent out to jazz clubs. We would usually have an artist in residence that would come into Kansas City, which didn't happen in 2020, or isn't happening, I guess. But we do have several of the jazz venues that are part of the venue showcase this year. You'll see those listed on that spotlightcharlieparker.org schedule. So you can still go out, you can still enjoy live jazz. And then the other track is an educational-related track, and what can we learn, right? So what can we share and information that we can share about Parker and his impact? So there's two tracks that are out there, education and venue showcase. The first item that's actually on the spotlightcharlieparker.org schedule is the Saxophone Supreme, and this was a project done in conjunction with the American Jazz Museum. It was Chuck Haddock's and Jerry Sanders that pulled this together. It's an amazing exhibit. It actually opened July 19th, and it's going to be available, I believe, throughout the rest of the calendar year, a changing gallery at the American Jazz Museum, one of the educational events. And as you mentioned, August kicked off with jazz storytelling. Again, a great opportunity. Lisa Henry's been doing that at the American Jazz Museum for years. This one was focused all around the life of Charlie Parker. We had a tie-in event on August 11th with Charles Perkins, Gerald Spates, through Polsky Theater over at the Johnson County Community College. Another one that would fall into the venue showcase, student jam session at the 424 Lounge. That's up in Leavenworth. That was August 15th. Dialing into August 21st, we've got another event at the Gem Theater, and this is a little mini-series that is being pulled together again, down at the Jazz District. This upcoming weekend on the 22nd, is going to be, I think, really going to be a fun, obviously, education-related event, is the Bird Boot Camp. This event has actually sold out, so no more room for kids. About 14 professional musicians, guys like Bobby Watson, Dan Thomas, blah, blah, blah. So people that are carrying the Charlie Parker flag very, very high will be there to work with the kids. Chris Burnett has coordinated this. He also did this last year and has just done an amazing job. Kids will come in. I think check-in starts at 9 o'clock in the morning. They'll go throughout the day. There's a website, birdbootcamp.org, that he has pulled together for that. All those details are on there. This is actually going to release at 3:45. They're going to wrap up the Bird Boot Camp, and the musicians, the kids, I'm sure we'll have some elder statesmen, so we've got multiple generations coming out of the Gem Theater, lining up along 18th Street, maybe in front of the Gem Theater. I'm not sure if there will be enough room to social distance everybody. I don't know if they'll be on both sides of the street, but it's going to be a very, I think, cool experience to watch that sax salute to Charlie Parker, and that'll happen at 4 o'clock. We're hoping we'll get some media down there, maybe have this televised. This is one that I think could actually get some international, national, international airplay. Again, multiple generations coming together, celebrating Charlie Parker, social distance.
You know, the one thing about this celebration, as you had mentioned, since the word goes, that Kansas City has kind of gone through its own level of renaissance. There's, before this pandemic hit, I mean, there were clubs everywhere. I mean, there were cats playing. The schedule was huge. People were moving here. Bobby was retiring and had done such a wonderful job of cultivating such a cauldron of talent in this town. And the interesting thing was each year this would happen, it would just be kind of like a grand, you know, outgrowth of what was already going on. It seems like this year it's a level of recovery and rebirth for this town, a level of us getting our foothold and saying, you know what, we're not going to let this pandemic stop us.
Yeah, I'd absolutely agree.
What are your thoughts on this in the grand scheme of Kansas City and the world of jazz at large recovering from such a huge, tremendous, well, I mean, the arts have been destroyed by this, and this has to be some way, even with the Bobby Watson concert that was outside, you mentioned Jackie Myers is going to have a show outside. I mean, these have to be very poignant, like, events in the recovery of jazz and Kansas City.
They are, and it's interesting. We are working closely. Jam Pool Artist Management is actually who you license through when you're going to going to use Charlie Parker's name and you're going to make a spotlight Charlie Parker. You need to go talk to Jam Pool Artist Management and procure your licensing. And they have been an amazing partner this year. Obviously, with the 100th birthday, they were planning on some really big events kind of happening all around the country. And as we were continuing to plan, I was keeping in touch with them on a regular basis. And he would check in and be like, you guys still doing this? And I'm like, this is Kansas City, baby. We're here. We'll be here. I don't know what it's going to look like yet, but we're going to be here. As the rest of the country, and I don't want to say everybody dropped, there's still actually several larger events that are happening around Charlie's 100th birthday. But I think the list continued to shrink, and ours continued to grow. You know, just it was a week or so ago I was talking to him, and he's like, this is just amazing. He's like, this is bigger than anything else in the country. And I said, yes, Kansas City's been doing something bigger than anybody else in the country for years. Here we are. It's good to see it all happen and good to see it come together.
So my final question is this. The hope is that we find people that don't know anything about Bird and these celebrations just illuminate, because there's a lot of people that do know about Bird, or there's those that at least have a working knowledge. But for those that don't and that actually discover Bird, why do people need to discover Bird? Those that don't know him, why would it be key that this celebration brings his life and music into somebody that has no idea who he is?
I think you could take that back to the history of Kansas City. Charlie Parker, jazz, this is what happened here. And as people start to explore more and learn more about the city and who we are and where did we come from, those things that bind together a city, bind together a community, shared experiences, you know, again, through Spotlight, you can go out in person and you can enjoy some of these events. You can go have brunch with Millie Edwards and Dan Sturdivant down at the Phoenix. You can go to the Black Dolphin, go to Casey Beer Company, get out there and be a part of it. If you're not quite ready for that, you can step back, you know, quietly from your own home, stream some of these various events that are happening out there. Everybody has the opportunity to participate and learn about the history that's out there and part of what really made Kansas City, Kansas City.
Well said. John, thanks for taking some time out to talk about the celebration. I look forward to it myself. I think it's going to be, you know, as much as everybody is really not happy with how 2020 panned out, I think one of the musicians I spoke with as the pandemic really revved up had an album that came out. He said to me, there's going to be a very special place for albums that are released during this pandemic, and I think it's going to be the same thing for celebrations and shows that will still carry on, not in the traditional way that we were used to prior to March 12th or 13th, but they're still doing it. I think there's something to be said about that.
Absolutely. Yeah, no, it's exciting to have all this happen, and we're just blessed. The musicians that we've got in Kansas City, the support that literally comes out of the woodwork to celebrate Charlie Parker is a true blessing. And again, there's a 20-something events that are out here. SpotlightCharlieParker.org has that latest schedule. I look forward to hopefully seeing people around, and if not, if you're staying safe at home, stream some of the events. We've got a full schedule, lots of fun stuff that's happening out there, and be able to bring a piece of that history forward.
Indeed. John, thanks for talking about it. Good luck with it this year, and we'll look for a big year this year in 2020.
Sounds great. Thanks, Joe. Appreciate your time.
Thanks for listening and tuning in to another Neon Jazz interview, where we give you a bit of insight into the finest cats in New Orleans, New York City, Kansas City, and spots all over the world, giving fans all that jazz. And thanks to John for his time, music, and stories. If you want to hear more interviews, go to Famous Interviews with Joe Domino in the iTunes Store. Visit NeonJazz at YouTube.com, and for everything Neon Jazz all the time, go to theneonjazz.blogspot.com. Until next time, enjoy the jazz, my friends.
Neon Jazz.